Okay, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, yeah, why so soft? Because watch too much sea game already, is it? All right, welcome. Actually, I'm very glad to see a lot of you guys here because we all know that nowadays the financial market, especially the stock market, are a bit volatile, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so that's why I'm here this morning together with another two speakers to share you guys where we see the global market will be going. For me, is I'll be talking more about the US stock market. Alright? So, yeah. So my topic for today is investment trends and opportunities in different asset classes. Alright? Okay, before I go on, I'd just like to check. How many of you guys actually over here is the first time to see me today? Can I have a show of hands, please? Wow, so many. Okay. Then if... Let me just check with you guys, is it okay if I just do a very brief introduction of myself? Is it okay? A very brief one, at least you know who am I, right? Can I? Yeah, have some more response, can I? Yeah, like, it's such a nice place, Garena. Alright? So my name is Derek Tan, I'm a Singaporean, in case you don't know how a Singaporean look like. Like that. Alright, so I've been trading in the financial market for the last 18 years. Since 1999, all right, full-time. So I've been a full-time trader as well as investors in the so-called stock market, commodities, currency, bond, and property market for the last 18 years, all right. At the same time, I'm also the founder of this program called Timing and You. And for me, is I know, you guys know that there are several forms of analysis in the market. The first one is what we call FA, Fundamental Analysis, made known by Mr. Warren Buffett, right? Ladies and gentlemen, do you think that there's a lot of value in the market right now? Do you think so? Maybe there is, but personally, I don't view so. We are definitely in the last stage of the bull run already. Do you guys agree? Or you feel that this bull run still got 10 years to go? Everything got a cycle. Do you guys agree? Yes? This bull run started in March 2009, if you guys remember. 2009 March until now is about 8 years, right? Later I'll show you guys, in fact, we are in the second longest bull run in history. Second longest, still not the longest yet. The longest was in the Nasdaq bubble in year 2000. Alright? We are in the 101 month of the bull market. Alright? It is a very old bull already. So if you feel that this bull is going to run for another 5, 10 years, I will disappoint you. Alright? Because everything, there's a cycle. Alright? So anyway, there's this thing called technical analysis whereby you look at prices, break resistance, you buy, break support, you sell, all of this. Then for me, is I do this thing called cycle analysis. Alright? What is cycle analysis? It's actually a field of study in analyzing recurring pattern to forecast timing and turning point of different investment asset classes. Alright, so for me is, because I do, I know FA, I know TA, and I'm so-called specialized in CA, cycle analysis. So that's why I'm also known as Mr. Cycle and or Cycle Engineer. I used to be engineer, just to check. Any engineers here, any engineers? Oh, Malaysia, very few engineers. Oh, Singapore, a lot. Alright, so, so that's that, alright? So, later I'll show you guys some of the cycle charts of different asset classes. Because with that, we can do forecasts for example, the stock market, or even for the oil, for gold, all this, alright? So, I give talks around different parts of the world like Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, China, Myanmar, all this, alright? I'm also featured in the Smart Investor, in the Age magazine, all right? So now, this morning, whatever I share this morning is just my personal view. It's only for information and purpose, education purpose only. It is not a recommendation to buy or to sell any investment, asset classes, stocks or whatever. Are we all agreeable on this? Yes or no? Yes, if you all need professional advice, who should you all look for? There are a lot of swagger mainly wearing green, right? They are from Kananga, they are the so-called the professionals. Please look for them for any advice or any talk about the financial market, alright? So now, I believe a lot of you guys attend a lot of talks, so I need to give you guys my definition of a time frame so that you guys will have some understanding. Alright, for me, short term is anything less than 1 month. Alright, anything less than 1 month is considered short term. Alright, it could be a few weeks. Alright, for me, I'm not an intraday player. You know what's an intraday? That means you play within 1 day. That means morning you buy, before market close you sell. I'm not this kind because I travel around, I'm very busy, so I don't have time for intraday. Maybe in my younger days, yes, but not now. Alright? So intermediate term is from 1 month to less than 1 year. I'm more of an intermediate term player. Alright? Long term is from 1 year to less than 10 years. Alright? So for me, I'm more of this intermediate term trader or investor, you can call me. Alright? So do take note of that. Alright? So now, let's talk about the first one, U.S. stock market. I'm just curious, can we do a survey? I would like to do a survey here first. How many of you guys are actually trading the U.S. stock market already? Can I have a show of hands, please? Trading the... Oh, so few. Okay. May I know the rest who didn't put up your hand, may I know what's the reason? Any reason why? Too far away. Distance is not a problem because there's this thing called internet, right? Alright, so most of you guys are still trading the Malaysia market, right? Alright, so maybe this morning, after hearing what I say, I may just trigger your interest in the US stock market. I hope so, that's my job. If I fail to do so, next time you all won't see me already because another will not engage me anymore. Alright, but the thing is, ladies and gentlemen, U.S. stock market. How many of you guys actually over here feel that U.S. stock market is very topish, it's going to crash soon, eh? Can I have a show of hand? So few. Then, how many of you feel that, wow, can still keep on going up and up and up from here? How many of you guys? Then the rest, eh? The rest is whatever I ask, you also won't raise your hand, right? Okay. The thing is, I don't think we are going to crash it. The fundamental reason for US stock market to crash is not here yet. We are near, but we are not there yet. Alright? We can see 差不多 level, but we are not there yet. I'll share with you guys why. So let's talk about US stock market. So now, this is something very interesting. Let's look at this chart together. You guys can take photo if you want. Alright, so this is the chart or these are statistics of so-called the last 10 major bull and bear market that occur in S&P 500. You all know S&P 500, right? It's one of the major US indexes. The most recent bear market in the US stock market is which one? Have some response. You know it's in front of so many people standing on stage or no response, you feel very bad, no? Alright? It's a subprime crisis, correct? It's the 2007, correct? No? Alright? So that is actually the last one. The global financial crisis. Actually, it started in October 2007. This portion here is actually bear market. This portion here is actually bull market. So let's look at the last one. This is the most recent global financial crisis. It started around October 2007. It crashed 57%. Its duration is about 17 months. So after that, it started to bottom out around March 2009, correct? Or it has been going up and up. We are in our 101 month of bull market already. Alright? And based on S&P 500, it has went up 274%. Alright, so we look at the previous one, it was a tech bubble, year 2000, it crashed 50%, duration about 21, alright, so the upside, it was about 61%. So, I don't go through all, the thing, maybe the most, just one of this, 1987, was the Black Monday, remember? Down so one night drop about 19 October 1987, remember? Huh? Boy, a lot of you haven't born yet. 1987, 19 October, Black Monday, right? Dow Jones 19 drop, collapse by 23%. Alright, then if you go on, of course the biggest one is the Great Depression. So now, ladies and gentlemen, what can we learn from this? What can we learn from this? Based on these 10 major bear markets, it seems that based on this 10, the average drop is about 45%, can you see? And the duration is about 25 months. So the thing is, based on the last previous 10 bear market, every time it crashed about 50%, can you see? Then every time the bear market lasts about 2 years, can you see that? So ladies and gentlemen, next time if bear market come again, you roughly will know 50%, you should do something, right? Then it's about 1 year plus 2 years, you should know what to do, right? So this is a very important chart. So now, let's look at the bull market over here. What I want you all to focus is over here, we are in the 101. The longest of the bull market run is 115 months. Well, we are 101, that means we have another, if based on this, we are the second longest bull market already, correct? Alright, so I don't know whether this will, I think we will catch up with this. Whether we'll surpass 115, I don't know, but I don't think we have ended already. Alright, so in terms of duration, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the second longest bull market in the US stock market. Do you agree that if the global market is affected by the US stock market? I think it's... Alright, so if US market continue to go up, probably we'll see other market, maybe KLCI as well, Singapore market, all this, to go up as well. Alright? So do take note, we are in the second longest bull market. It doesn't mean it's going to crash yet. I'm just showing you in terms of duration. Is it okay? Can I? So now, in terms of fundamental, I know a lot of you guys know at fundamentals. This is a very popular fundamental indicators a lot of people look at. It's called Shiller P/E ratio. Alright? So now it's about over here. Well, cannot really see clearly here. Down here is about year 2000, the Nasdaq bubble. Alright, down here it was the 1929 Great Depression. So in terms of valuation, we are considered relatively high, correct? Oh yeah. If you your answer is yes, you don't need to say yes, you can you just like that? If your answer is no, then you're like that, can don't need to answer, it's okay. But have some response, can. Because I hope you all can learn something within this next 1.5 hour, 1 hour 15 minutes. Is it okay? Good, huh? So ladies and gentlemen, in terms of valuation, if you look at this, maybe in terms of valuation, it's a bit high for the US market. Alright? And in terms of duration, we are in the second longest bull market already. But the thing I can tell you is this, I don't feel that this bull market is going to end soon. Why? Because this is a very important chart we all should be looking at. Alright? I always believe in this because I do cycle analysis. I believe in looking at history to predict the future. Because everything has a cycle. When it goes down, it has to go up. When it goes up, it has to come down. Agree now? Be it in financial market, be it in our life. Do you agree with that? Yes, right? Also with that, let's look back history, ladies and gentlemen. Let's look back history. This is where we are right now. Anyway, the white line, this white line is actually the S&P 500. Alright? Can you see this orange line here? This is actually the Federal Reserve Fund rate. So right now, S&P 500, right now we are about 2,400 plus, right? Alright? The fund rate is about 1 to 1.25 around here. Let's look back history, the last crisis, which crisis is that? Or the last bull market, bear market? Subprime crisis, right? It was around 2007, right? Can you see S&P collapsed by 52%? And the reason was subprime crisis, and the fund rate was about 5%, slightly more than 5%. Can you see that? Can you see that? Yeah. So then the previous bear market, it was a dot-com bubble, year 2000. S&P collapsed by 46%. The fund rate was about probably 6%, 7%. Can you see that? All right? And if you go back, the fund rate used to be about almost close to 20% before, no? That was in the 1980s. Because the Paul Volcker, the former Federal Reserve Chairman, because of very high inflation, so he keep on increasing interest, remember? Oh, you're too young, cannot remember, I'm old man really. So I can remember, all right? So the thing I want to say is this, ladies and gentlemen, if you compare at least to the previous two bear market, where the fund rate is about 5 to 7%, we are only about 1 to 1.25%, can you see that? So based on historical data, ladies and gentlemen, the fundamental reason for the stock market to crash is not here yet. But once it starts to go up to 2%, 3%, then we need to be worried, you understand? There's a myth in the financial market, they say, whatever interest rate go up, stock market will come down, right? These are hard data. Let's look at hard data. When interest rate starts to go up, this is low, right? Interest rates are going up, right? Right? What happened to the stock market? It go up. Can you see that? So the thing is, during the initial part of the interest rate increase, stock market will follow, you understand? So that's why we are still in the initial stage. For example, since 2007, 2008, Federal Reserve came out reduced interest rate almost to zero, right? It's until end of 2015, they first time increased interest rate, correct? Right? Then the second time, it was end of 2016, correct? This year, March, the third time, right? Then June, the fourth time, correct? Correct, right? So we are still in the initial phase of the tightening. So please, ladies and gentlemen, yeah, it looks high, S&P 500 look high, or even the US stock market look high. In terms of duration, the second longest bull market in the whole world, the valuation, the PE ratio look high, but the thing is, the most fundamental reason, interest rate is still very low. You understand what I'm saying? So please, the US stock market is not going to crash yet. We are on the way. We can see there already, but we are not there yet. You understand? All right, so please take note. So in fact, this is what I see in terms of S&P 500. For those of you who know Elliott Wave, all right, Wave 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 09 March, we started the Wave 1. We went through a consolidation, Wave 2, Wave 3, Wave 4. I believe we are in the last wave already. It should be the last leg already. This last leg, I see it should stretch until next year. Probably, it got power, maybe latest 2019. But I doubt so, it should be next year already. And ladies and gentlemen, last leg is always, to me, my experience, last legs normally got a lot of meat, you know what's meat, right? You can make a lot of money, right? Don't miss this chance. You understand what I'm saying? Don't listen to this guy. He's really treating the US government or the whole US like his own Trump organization, right? Do you realize his turnover rate very high? He can fire the FBI director. Then recently the manufacturing council, all the business leader left, right? Oh, y'all don't follow. Also, his turnover is very high, one. So as a company leader, he's quite an interesting guy, right? And he said recently that he may want to shut down US government, right? Because the debt ceiling is coming up at the end of September, right? Just because he want to build one wall, right? Because he said during the election, I say I want to build the wall, right, between US and Mexico, right? And he's a very persistent person. He said, if I don't build it, I'm going to shut down US government. Well, like that one, right? Well, I think Trump called already. I'm joking. Alright, so I believe we are in the last wave. Alright? But the thing is, do you guys agree that in every phase of the stock market, there need to be different strategies? Do you guys agree? Right? Personally, for me, and I'm always wrong. Personally, for me, I don't see a lot of values in the so-called financial market. Probably in the commodity market. Alright? I don't really see a value. In fact, in this phase, last phase of the stock market bull run, the strategy I'm using right now, or I think a lot of people is looking at, should be buy high, sell higher. Because we are in the last run already. Also, I think the better strategy will be buy high, sell higher. I believe there are people who don't agree, it's okay, it's just my personal opinion. Alright? Remember the disclaimer? Alright? So now, then where do I see the US stock market will go up to? Based on right now, whatever I see, this down zone, down zone. Right now we are going through a correction, do you all know that? This correction may take some time, but don't be fooled by it. My take is don't be fooled by it, because after this correction, I believe the next resistance for down zone should be around 23 to 24,000. Then, probably, at this point of time I see, probably that should be it already. Unless Donald Trump going to do something funny again. Alright? I think it should be about red. Alright, then we should see it come down. Alright, come down already. What I forecast is next few years, it will go straight back up again. You will see a slingshot. I'm forecasting a down zone hitting 30,000 or more. But that is later on. Let's reach this 23 to 24,000 first, can? Alright, the thing I want to say is this. Right now, we are actually going through a correction, ladies and gentlemen. Please, don't after here this morning when I say, what, Monday, should we go and buy US stock? Because we are going through a correction. In fact, right now, a lot of our central bankers are gathering in this place called Jackson Hole, right? I don't know why the name is called Jackson Hole. Jackson Hole some more, I don't know why. So the thing is, anyway, the Mario is there, right? ECB president. And of course, our dear Janet Yellen is there, right? Alright? So the thing is, they are discussing a lot of stuff over there. So the thing is this, ladies and gentlemen, right now we are at the end of August, right? Today is 26, alright? If you look through historically, August, September, October, historically, are the weakest month of the year for the stock market. Historically. Weakest doesn't mean you will crash. Weakest means compared to January, February, March, April, May, June, July, and November, December. August, September, October seems to be the weakest. You understand what I'm trying to say? Alright? So, as mentioned here, an S&P 500 has just broken below, this is the 50-day moving average. Can you see it has broken below the 50-day moving average? I've drawn a downtrend line. Alright, and this is the latest data. Last night, S&P tried to break above this downtrend line, cannot. And it came down and it closed low. Can you see that? So the thing is, it seems that this 50-day moving average is posing as a resistance for S&P 500. And this is a sign that the market rally is losing out of steam already. Alright? I'm looking at probably, if it continue to come down, it may find support around here, 2004. If things get worse, it should be finding support around the 200-day moving average. Is it okay?
Yes.
Well, you're like confused already. Can? Oh, okay. Alright? My job is, it cannot convince you all, my job is to confuse you all. So if you are confused, who do you all look for? Those people went in the red, they are the expert. My job is to confuse you guys. No, so now, the second thing is, the percentage of the S&P stocks hitting new 50, doing low, is now near 8%. Alright, this is a level higher than the market sell-off before the US presidential election. Alright, and the Brexit. This is another warning sign for the US stock market. Alright? The third thing is this. The mid-cap, especially the small caps in the US stock market, are performing relatively weak compared to a large cap. This is a sign that a few stocks are holding up the major indexes. I particularly look at the small cap. Because why small cap? Because small cap, they are more sensitive to investors' sentiment. Alright, they are more sensitive to economy. So-called performance. So, if you look at the small cap in US market, it's represented, one of the index you can look at is Russell 2000. Alright, this is the chart, Russell 2000. Can you see how it has come down? Break the 50-day moving average, break the 200-day moving average. Ladies and gentlemen, do take note, 50-day moving average is the moving average looked by who? By the bankers, by the institution. So normally when they see a stock or ETF or index break 50-day, they kanchiong ready. They will start to sell, you understand? 200-day moving average is more for long-term investor. Alright? So the thing is, look at this, it has break 50-day, break 200-day, what do you think? A lot of banker, institution, even long-term investors, zao already, right? You understand what I'm saying? So then it came down, it went up to test this 200-day again. Can you see that? As of now, it is not able to break the 200-day. So ladies and gentlemen, this represents the small cap. And small cap, I say, is a representative of the general market breadth in the whole US stock market, right? So that's why I can tell you, in terms of short-term US stock market, I believe, and past the seasonality reason, I believe we should be going through a short-term correction. And historically, the worst hit is actually September, which is next month. So if you feel, wow, drop enough already, I think still got some more. Alright? So do take note of that. Also, for those who are more adventurous, you feel that you want to take this opportunity to short the market before you want. You all know what short selling? Normally, how you all make money from stock market is when you buy stock from $1, go up to $2, you sell at $2, you make $1, you make money, right? But now, is if your stock market is coming down, you cannot buy high, sell low. Cannot, right? So what you do is you do this thing called short selling. And short selling, there's a so-called, this thing called inverse ETF. All this inverse ETF is available in CanTrade, in Kenangan platform. You can look for the dealers and reminders to talk to them more about all this. There's this thing called, in US stock market, the stock is actually represented by symbol. If you want to short the down zone, it's actually called DOG. If you want to short the Nasdaq, is PSQ. You want to short S&P 500, is SH. Alright? So, if you feel that this correction may be persisting and you want to short the market, these are the ETF that you can look at to short sell. You buy into this inverse ETF to short sell all these indexes. Is it okay? Can, Alright? And all these ETF is available where? Kenangan, CanTrade, alright? Also, the thing is this, ladies and gentlemen, another thing I need you all to take note is this. Please take note of this US 10-year treasury. That means the US 10-year bonds. You all know what's bonds, right? Alright? Right now, do you all know what is the percentage for the US 10-year treasury? You. As of last night, 2.17. 2.17. So the thing is, look at the last one. When the US 10-year treasury yield less than 2.3, is look out for below for the US stocks worldwide, we may finally get that long overdue stock market correction, which is what we are going through right now already. Okay? But once it starts to go up to 2.3 to 2.7%, alright, stocks will be ranging between 19,500 and 21,500 for down zone, plus minus 10%. But once it goes up more than 2.7%, that means that the stocks are going to hit higher, much higher, as shown in here. Alright, so right now, we are here right now, because we are about 2.17%. Don't believe me, I just check only. You all can check yourself. We are right now here, so with this, we are going for long overdue stock market correction. I hope can be about 5%, I hope. Alright? So down here is here. But do take note that once it hit more than 2.7%, ladies and gentlemen, we should be seeing a US stock market going much higher. But one thing to take note of is this, ladies and gentlemen. Once this US 10-year treasury yield hit 3%, once it hit 3%, is red alert. Red alert means what? Wait, do y'all know U and bump prices, they are opposite one, do y'all know that? This is U one. So if the so-called U actually go up, what happened to our bond prices? Yeah, opposite, no or nothing, right? If U were to go up, bond prices will come down. So the thing is, if it hit 3% and above, it means that the bond prices is coming down and crashing, you understand? If it's go, that's why I say, when it go beyond 3%, and ladies and gentlemen, think about US 10-year treasury. Who are the buyers of this US 10-year treasury? Central bank, central government, all this, right? China, right? Japan, right? So ladies and gentlemen, if it's go up to 3%, that means what? The bond prices of all this coming down, right? So it is coming down. That means most likely maybe the central bankers or the institutional investors, they may know something. That's why they are selling down the bonds. Can you see that? You understand? Also, what is the percentage to wash out? Which is the percentage? What is the percentage? Huh? 3%, huh? 3%. Don't worry, we are 2.17% as of last night. Still got some way. At least still have to go from here to here to here. Then 3%. Can you see that? That's why I can tell you over here, the US stock market still got some room to run. You understand? Not going to crash yet. Is it okay or not? Can Okay, very good. So now, I'm going to show you guys the cycle chart. This is something I specialize in. This is my cycle chart for down zone. It actually represents the major US so-called indexes. Do take note, cycle chart, if y'all can take, but I will let y'all know there's an expiry date for this cycle chart. It ends until November. Alright, so you don't see until what, then go until 2018, 2019, no what? Because it expired until November this year. Alright, this is a cycle chart for down zone. I already say I'm an intermediate term. Intermediate term, that means more than a month, less than 1 year, right? Correct? So now, this is May, June, July, August, September, October, November. So we are somewhere around here, correct? End of August, correct? Ladies and gentlemen, earlier remember I say cycle analysis is about forecasting the performance of the different asset classes is in terms of timing and turning point, correct? Remember? So ladies and gentlemen, where I see down zone of the US stock market going forward is probably we'll see gold continue to turn down, finally have a turning point around middle of September. Can you see that? Then it will probably turn up. So that's why my take is this. I think the weakness in the US stock market will continue, probably based on this cycle chart until middle of September, before it can turn up. So meanwhile, during this downturn, what you can do is, if you want to profit, for those who are more adventurous, you can buy into all this inverse ETF to short the US market, right? Then later on, when it starts to turn up, ladies and gentlemen, these are the few sectors that I think you guys can look at, you can look at to long the US stock market. The three major sectors that I personally look at is defense, financial, and technology. So in terms of defense, you know this guy, I think I read this morning, he just fired some missile again, right? He just fired. Nothing to do, sometimes you just press one. It's like that. So that's why this guy, Donald Trump, not very happy with him. So now, that's why Congress, US Congress, proposed a defense budget of $37 billion higher than Trump's. Trump's administration only wants $603 billion. But US Congress actually proposed $640 billion. $37 billion more. Donald Trump only wants $603 billion. Congress said, no, give you $37 billion more. You understand? Because of this guy. So the thing is, based on this, that's why I feel that the defense sector will benefit. And one of the so-called ETF that you can buy into that will benefit from this will actually be actually we can look at the ETF. It's actually, the symbol is actually called ITA. We can look at it. ITA, yes. It's actually iShares US Aerospace and Defense ETF. ETF means exchange traded fund. It includes most of some of the so-called the defense stocks in the so-called US stock market, like LMT, Lockheed Martin, a defense stock, all right? So can you see it has been going up and up and up, especially over here because North Korea go and launch a few missile, then the Donald Trump say he's very angry, going to start a war. Well, you don't follow news, huh? Maybe you all focus on C game, right? Must be, anyway, at the other side of the world, all right, so it has been going up. And now, can you see that there's a correction? Because generally, because now the small boy stopped firing, but last yesterday fired again. All right, so the thing is, watch out. The thing is, I think this is a good ETF you can look at to ride on this rally in the defense sector. Is it okay? Yeah, if you want. Anyway, the 50-day moving average, 200-day, all moving out, that means it's still in the uptrend. Can you see that? Alright, if you all want to know more about all these ETF or stock, who do you look for? People like Jason. Alright, can I? So then if you all want to look at individual defense stock, maybe I'll just show you one. Is the symbol is L here, Jason. LFT. Jason here, Jason. LMT. Yeah, Lockheed Martin. Can you see also very nice? Also uptrending. So it's a good defense stock in the US stock market. Alright? Can I move on? No response again. Can I drink water first? We can look at this ITA, the ETF, and one of the stock. Then the second sector we can look at is financial sector. Why do I say that? My thing is, I believe the way I look at it is, we may see another interest rate increase probably end of this year by Federal Reserve. I don't think it's September. Because do you know what is holding back the Federal Reserve from increasing the interest rate? Yes, they are looking at the inflation number. The inflation number is not really up to 2%, right? It has been declining, so they are holding back. But later I'll show guys, if you look at the underlying so-called commodity market, it's actually starting to rebound already. So that's why I think we may have a chance to have another one more time, rate increase end of the year. Alright, later I'll show guys. So with the interest rate increase, which sector will benefit? Bank. The thing is, you don't say, wow, interest rate increase, then the bank will increase our saving deposit, the interest rate, right? Do you think so? That will be the last thing they will do, you understand? First thing they will do is they will increase the interest rate for mortgage. Because they want to make money first, man. You understand what I'm saying? Alright, so in terms of financial, if you want, you can look for ETF. Jason, we can look for ETF in the financial sector in the US market. It's called XLF. XLF. Yes. Second one. Yeah. Financial Select Sector SPDR Fund. Alright? It seems to be finding support at 50-day. If you can clear this downtrend line, probably you can go up more from here. Alright? So I believe one of the sectors that will benefit from the interest rate increase probably will be financial. And ladies and gentlemen, please don't think that Federal Reserve can keep the interest rate low for too long. Because they have been keeping it low for too long already, they are actually creating another crisis. Do you all know that? The crisis where? In the pension fund. You know what's pension fund? Pension fund means, especially in the US market, that means a lot of retired people, as they work, they put money into their pension fund, right? To prepare for pension mark. So the thing is this, pension fund, they are not supposed to invest in risky assets. They have to invest in stable, safe asset, right? Which will be like what? Bond, fixed deposit, right? All this is tied to what? Interest rate, right? With the interest rate so low, all these pension fund, they cannot apply their obligation to all these pensioners, you understand? That's why if they keep the interest rate so low, a lot of pension fund will collapse, you understand what I'm saying? So there's no way Federal Reserve can keep the interest rate too low. They have to increase it already, you understand? Or? Cannot. Alright, so do take note, going forward, I believe maybe end of this year, one more time. Next year, probably we'll see more. And until finally, it keep on going up, interest rate keep on going up, then the stock market keep on going up, until, boom, the thing burst. You understand? I'm showing you all what is coming up for the next maybe 1, 2, or 3 years. Get prepared for it. Can I? Can I? Very good. So then if you want to look for individual so-called financial stock, probably you can look at JPM, which is JP Morgan. Alright? You all know JP Morgan, right? One of the investment bank. Probably going to, can you find support at 50-day moving average? If it goes up, do you all know what this looks like? Technical analysis, huh? If it goes up, it probably looks like a double bottom, correct? Okay. You all don't know technical analysis. You all want to learn technical analysis? Don't want also. If you all want to learn, you all can learn from who? Can learn from me, I know what, but today not about technical analysis. If you all learn from one of the technical analysis, you all can ask Kananga to engage me to teach your technical analysis. Cannot? Cannot, okay. So, Esther? Alright, so, but look, ladies and gentlemen, this is a 50 day. Probably if it goes up, break this resistance here, around maybe 94, we may see JP Morgan go up further from here. Is it okay? Cannot? Let's go back to our slide. So now, the next sector that I'm quite favorable is this sector called technology. Alright, recently all the FANG stock has been running at FANG stock. FANG stock is a F-A-A-N-G, for the FANG, F, Facebook, A, Amazon, Apple. Amazon hit 1,000, then came down, right? Okay. N, Netflix, G, Google. Then there's another one that I think is very good one. Do you all use this? It's China company. But yes, it's called Alibaba. Alright, it has been going up and up and up. Do you all know that? And I think it's just a beginning. Alright, so another good, this is something that we can look at. So maybe you can go to a chart. For technology sector, if you don't want to buy individual stock, there's ETF also. It's actually called XLK. Technology select sector SPDR fund. Can you see it has been going up and up and up and up? Now it's hovering around here. Once it can break out from this ranging, this consolidation phase, it may go up from there. Can you see that? So once you buy into this XLK, you are actually buying, because this ETF include what? Include Apple, include Facebook. So you feel that buy individual stock too much money, then buy this only $58.50 only. Alright, you buy into this, you are investing in all the Apple, Facebook, all this thing. Can? Very good. So come, let's go back. Yeah, we still got time. Come on. I need another 1 hour. Just joking. Alright, so then if you feel that you want to long the US stock, US indexes, these are the US indexes you can buy to ride the US stock market up. For Dow Jones will be DIA, S&P 500 will be SPY, QQQ, NASDAQ will be UDOW. All right? Next, I'm going to talk about this thing called US dollar. US dollar has been dropping and dropping and dropping, correct? In case you all don't know, it has been dropping since the beginning of the year, correct? Alright, how many of you guys feel that the US dollar will continue to drop some more? Can I have a show of hand? Oh, very good. I always like to do survey. How many of you guys feel that drop about there, it should rebound from there? Can I have a show of hand? And the rest? I think it's half bearish, half bullish. My take is I'm not so bearish. I think the downside may not be too much really. Let me just show you guys why. This is US dollar index. US dollar index. Since 2008 until right now, this is a monthly chart. It's a daily chart, but from 2008 until now. So can you see since early this year, US dollar index has been dropping, can you see that? Right? But also, can you see, it seems to be coming near to this support around 92 over here. Can you see that? This 92 support, if from the low of 2014, you use this thing called Fibonacci. You know Fibonacci? Okay. So if you don't know Fibonacci, you can learn from someone, right? This called technical analysis. Learn from who? Derek Tan, can. So Fibonacci, can you see, if you use 50%, it's also around 92. Can you see that? You understand what I'm saying? That means this 92 level seems to have a support here as well as a 50% Fibonacci retracement. Can you see that? So this 92 level seems to be quite a strong support based on this low of 2014. But for US dollar index, the lowest is actually in 08. So we look at the next chart. Next chart, if I use the Fibonacci, I draw again, I come down. Can you see there's a high here? This around 88 seems to be having some support over here also. Can you see that? Correct? Then based on this around here, can you see another 50%? Based on the low of 2008. So based on that, it seems that another support may be around 88. Can you see that? So that's why I see is this. Around 88 to 92, we should have a good support, be it in terms of horizontal support or be it in terms of Fibonacci retracement. Alright? Ladies and gentlemen, another thing to share with you guys is this. If you look through history, within 1 year, the currency of that particular country, US dollar, euro, it will only go up or down 15% at most. If you look through historically, 15%. So now, the highest over here is about 104. Can you see? So please help me, take out your calculator. 15% discount, how much is that from 104? Highest 104, 15% discount. How much? 88, right? So can you see 88 is around here based on this support and based on this Fibonacci resistance. Can you see that? So my take is this, ladies and gentlemen, if you feel that US dollar is going to continue to drop, I can tell you, not likely. Because first central banker will not allow that to happen, you understand? Alright, of course, Donald Trump wants US dollar weaken so that it can improve their export, right? But you don't think that US dollar strengthen, other currency will be affected also, no? Example, because of that, Euro has been going up, right? Alright, let's look at another chart. This is US dollar. This is 209, 10, 11, until 17. Remember, USD QE, quantitative easing? This is the performance of US dollar. After QE1, US dollar dropped. Can you see that? This is a monthly chart. Then QE2, US dollar drop. QE3, US dollar drop. Then Federal Reserve start to taper their QE when? You all remember? It's actually end of 2013. They taper taper, that means they reduce the amount of bond they're going to purchase. They taper taper until it end in October 2014. That's why you look here. It started in end 2013, then end around end QE here. Can you see US dollar actually went up? Can you see that? So now the rumor is this. ECB President Mario say he may want to taper QE, right? I can tell you, all the central banks normally they follow what Federal Reserve do one. Alright, so if history were to repeat itself, when the so-called Federal Reserve taper QE and QE ends, US dollar went up. Can you see that? So now Mario says he wants to also taper their QE, right? So what happened to Euro? Went up more. Also, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Also because US dollar has been coming down, so relatively Euro is going up. Can you see that? So my take is this. I do not think that US dollar has much downside to go. Probably around here, a support. The later, the more it can go is around 88. That's it really. Alright, so the thing is, from here, I'm not saying after hitting this support zone, or it will go no. Probably it will hit, then it will go up. My take is, it will go up for the next few years. Alright, the next crisis, which I say is the sovereign debt crisis, is going to be caused because of very strong US dollar rally. Right? Think about it. If US dollar, the downside not much more, it's going to go up. If you go and invest in the US stock market, you make profit from there, assuming you make profit from there, then if US dollar strengthen, you convert your profit from US dollar back to ringgit, can you see you can make another currency gain? Can you see that? So that's why the more I suggest you guys can go and look at the US stock market. You understand what I'm saying? So I covered US dollar. And this is the cycle chart for US dollar. This is a cycle chart for US dollar. Same thing. Probably we have a turning point in the US dollar is gone up. Alright, so the turning point, it should be around now or it should be coming down. But if you look generally, US dollar should be turning up from here. That's why I say the support should be near already. The lowest, I think it should go probably around 88. That's about right. Alright. So the other thing I see is the commodity bull market is back. I just showed one chart. This is a chart of CRB. CRB stands for Commodity Research Bureau. It's an index for commodities. Wait, before, you all know what is commodity? Include oil, gold, wheat, all this, correct? This is a chart I show end of 2015. This is a fixed cycle chart of CRB. I say there's going to be a final bottom in first quarter 2016. I show this in end of 2015. Let's look at the chart of CRB right now. CRB. Can you see it has a lowest point around here? This 2016, probably around February. Is it first quarter 2016? February. First quarter means January, February, March, right? Correct. Alright, so can you see it has been going up, come down already. Fibonacci again around 68%. It has bounced up again. Can you see that? So probably my take is this. We should have seen the so-called the final low in commodity first quarter 2016 already. As like what I predicted in end 2015. Alright? So if you ask me, for example, oil, do you think oil will continue to drop off 40 la, 30 la, 20? You think so? Sorry la, I also hope so. I cannot la. If like that, Saudi Arabia will die. Alright? Not likely already, ladies and gentlemen. Alright? So the thing is, think about it, if commodity prices were to slowly turn up, means that inflation may be coming back, right? Means that Federal Reserve took an inflation number to decide the direction of the interest rate, right? So what do you think their next step? Most likely they will have to increase interest rate. You understand? Alright, this is what I see. Alright? So now for oil. Yeah, how much time do I have? Can I? Another 1 hour, can? Or you all want me to leave, man? I think you all don't really like me. Then it's okay. I think I'll end here. So anyway, let's talk about oil first. Let's look at the supply side. Ladies and gentlemen, take note, Saudi Arabia is going to go to IPO their state oil company called Aramco. Do you all know that? This is going to be a very big one. I believe it's going to be, if not the largest, one of the largest IPO in this whole world. Sound familiar? You all used to have the second largest, no? The largest until now, I think, is still Facebook, right? The second largest, right? F. Okay, y'all know Harry. So now the thing is, Saudi Arabia is going to lease their state-owned company called Saudi Aramco. To lease that, most likely they want to push up the so-called the oil project to make it look good. So supply side, we should. That's why Saudi Arabia has been cutting their so-called their oil production by 1 million per barrel. 1 million barrel per 1 million per barrel. 1 million barrel. Sorry. All right. Then U.S. supply is also tightening. For example, the storage hub for WTI, Western Texas Intermediate, fall in 15 out of the 16 weeks. So in terms of supplies, it is reducing, right? In terms of demand, we can actually see that the demand is going up, especially the demand in China. So ladies and gentlemen, simple economy 101, demand come down, supply come down, demand go up. What happens to the price? It will go up. A lot of geopolitical factor, all this thing, I no time to share about this. This is the cycle chart for oil. This is a cycle chart for oil. So right now, we are somewhere around here. Our oil may be weakening a bit, but can you see from probably middle of September onwards, oil price should be turning up. Also, my take is this. I don't think oil price has much downside to go really. I even doubt it can go below 40. I don't think so really. Most likely it will go up. No, right now maybe consolidating, go up, probably hit the resistance 55, clear 55, maybe 60. You understand? So this is a good news for Malaysia, right? Oh, you don't look very happy. If my country got a lot of oil, I should be very happy. But Singapore, no natural resources. Only very smart people. One more. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, I think oil price will turn up from here. So for those who are interested to run on this commodity bull market, these are the ETF that you can look at. For gold is GLD. You want to participate in the oil, it will be USO. Alright? These are the more liquid ETF that I found in the US stock market. And all this ETF is available where? Can trade. Also, please look for those who are wearing green, alright? So, ladies and gentlemen, I've almost come to the end of my presentation. So, if you feel that my sharing is good, please add me in my Facebook, alright? I'm Derek Tan. This is my page, my personal one already hit 5,000 already. So, please look for me. My cover picture is actually gold and silver. No, I believe in gold and silver. I have no chance to share today. Maybe later, I don't know. But, ladies and gentlemen, please have some gold and silver in your portfolio, especially gold. Because I believe you'll go a lot up from here because we are entering into a very messy period of time, what I know as a sovereign debt crisis. Alright? Now gold is facing resistance at 1,003, right? Alright? Once it clears that, I think we should be heading higher. Alright? So please like my page, alright? Don't like, cannot go up from this room. Alright? So with that, I end my presentation and may the timing with you guys. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Outlook. This is how the US getting stronger.
if you talk about regarding the chart, Ringgit, I'm not too optimistic. Anyway, I'm always wrong one, so it's okay. So whatever I say today, you all do opposite, she'll make money. USD against versus not Ringgit. Last year, I was talking about 4 point something. USD against Ringgit. Internet a bit slow. How about we take another question first, then don't need to look at chat while it's loading.
Use the time to discuss gold and silver, because you have the PowerPoints ready. No need
gold and silver, yeah. In that case, let's do it. Jason can look at my slide. Sorry, you want to look at gold and silver, right? This is the. I want to say again. All this cycle chart has an expiry date. It's until October or November. You don't think until 2018, 2019, it doesn't work this way. Alright? So now, this is the cycle chart for gold. I just crunched it yesterday. Today, 26 months. Alright, so going forward, I'm not too optimistic about gold going forward. Because I say already, US dollar may be bottoming out, right? In short term, US dollar strengthened, gold price will. Short term. But later on, probably going to 2019, 2020, 2021, 2022, we should be seeing gold price and US dollar going up together. This is a replay of what happened during the Great Depression. I no time to share all this. If you want to know more, I have a booth outside. You can check with my colleague outside. All right. So now, based on this, you can see that the gold price is weakening, right? It's weakening. All right. But the good thing is this. This until October, until end of this year, I foresee a big rally at the end of this year. See? And this, where? This is until early part of 2018, I foresee a big rally end of 2017 up. Why do I say this? Can go back to stockcharts.com. Can you key $? G-O-L-D. Yes. Let's go last 3 years. Listen, predetermined range. Last 3 years. So can you see, ladies and gentlemen, gold price was about 1,000, right? End of 2015, you see that? This 2016, this 2017. So 2015 for 1,000, gold price went up, you see that? Then it came down, end of 2016, it went up again, correct? Do you remember during this end of 2015, end of 2016, something happened? What happened? What happened? Federal Reserve increased interest rate. Remember? End of 2015 first time, right? End of 2016 second time, right? March 3rd time, right? June 4th time, right? So ladies and gentlemen, if we were to see Federal Reserve probably end of year increase one more time, maybe you understand what I'm saying? Also, my take is this, can go back to my slide. Probably that's why I think we may have a very strong rally probably end of this year. Alright? My take is this, sorry, can go back to stockchart.com. If you miss this around 1,000, if you miss around 1,120, probably you have missed the two second lowers already. Probably. So if there's a turn down again, can you see now there seems to be a resistance at 1,003. If it's turned down, this may be your last chance already. Probably if you draw a support line, maybe 1,002. But if you ask me, can go back to 1,000, not likely already. Because now then you all know me. If you all know me in 2015, then you all will have bought at 1,000. Too bad. But the thing I always say is this, it's better to be late than never, right? But you all don't agree, that's okay. Okay, so that's about goal. Alright, have I answered your question? Yes, sir. So I need to go back to Ringgit. Jason, this one. Still loading. This one. No, Jason, this one. Still loading. David.
Hey, morning, Derek.
Morning.
Hey, first time I listen to you. Thank you for the very interesting.
Not first time, last time ever.
Yeah, but
anyway, David is a very.
Please don't do that. Yeah.
My friend.
Yeah, very interesting presentation. Thank you for that. I've got just a very simple question. You mentioned that the 10-year US Treasury bond, when it hits 3%, right, that's a red alert to you. Just curious, why 3% and what's the rationale behind? Thanks.
Because I've done a lot of research, I go backward. I've done a lot of historical research. Because I do cycle analysis, I realize whenever a 10-year treasury hit 3%, it actually means a lot of institutions and central bankers, they're actually getting out from a 10-year treasury. That means, do you guys agree that all these central bankers, all these insurance funds, they know more, just something more about you and me, ordinary people? Do you guys agree? Definitely one. That's why they are there. You understand? For example, I give you an example. Do you know that George Soros has been shorting and shorting the US market? He has been buying a lot of options. Recently, the SEC issued him still buying more, shorting the US market. He can't be such a stupid person, right? He made the Bank of England collapse. That's why Dr. M doesn't really like him, right? Because of certain thing, right? So I don't think he's a stupid person. So because he must have known something, that's why he keep on buying option to short the US market. He may be a bit early, but I feel he's going in the right direction. Because they belong to that group, one, you understand? So now back to David's question is, because central banker or the institution, they must have known something. So if they see when he go beyond 3%, that means what? They are actually selling their 10-year treasury bond because 10-year treasury is considered safe haven. So if they are selling, that means they might know something, right? That's why once it hits 3%, we must re-alert, be prepared to, it may mean that the financial market is going to collapse already. That's my research that I've done. Alright? Yeah, is the chart ready? Yeah, I've got longer term one. No, can see the Bloomberg one, Bloomberg. Oh, no longer term one. 10 year. This 10 year. Ah, okay, 10 year. So, This is about 4.4, 4.5, right? My take is this. If for the next few years, I think US dollar is going to have a very strong rally. US dollar, very strong rally. What do you think will happen? We just say ringgit like that. US dollar going to be a very strong rally. What do you think? I don't need to say you answer the question yourself. Alright? This is what I think. Alright? Okay. And any more question?
Hi, good morning.
Sorry, where are you? Oh, okay.
Can you just quickly elaborate on what you think about this sovereign debt crisis?
Cannot very quickly. They need another 1 hour. But if you want, you can look for the person behind you. She's my student, Joyce, right? And you can share it up. But very quickly,
Okay, we have another question
here. No, very quickly. Very quickly. Can go to my slide. Very quickly, within 1 minute. We're going to have a sovereign debt crisis. It already started 2015, it's going to end in 2022. Sovereign debt crisis means there's going to be a crisis in the government. Government aware first is actually in Europe. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, yes, fundamentally, we may see the euro number getting better and GDP number, right? But ladies and gentlemen, I want to share you guys is this. You cannot, economy numbers are lagging indicators, do you know that? What are the leading indicators? Stock market indexes. Stock market lead economy by 6 months to 12 months. Then economy lead the property market 6 months to 12 months. You understand what I'm saying? So even though now you see the economy number from Germany, France, all this getting better, right? But this is for the previous quarter one, you understand? You understand? So the most leading indicator you should be looking at is the UM, the market indexes. I don't know whether, if you don't mind, let's go to stockcharts.com. Which is the largest economy in Germany, in Europe? Germany, it's called DAX. X. Second one. German DAX composite, you see for yourself. Germany, the largest economy in Europe, the DAX already break 50 days. Can you see that? Now it's finding support at 200 days. My take is, now is don't know, indecisive. That means what? I already say 50 days is what the bankers and institutions look at, right? That means what? The bankers and institutions may not be too optimistic already, right? Can you see that? Now this holding point will be the 200 days. Once it break 200 days, ladies and gentlemen, this is where I see going into next year, we are going to see a big drop in the European market as well as Euro because of a sovereign debt crisis in Europe. Okay? So this is the largest, second largest? Europe is this country called, they have a new president who has a very mature wife, CAC. Okay. No. Backspace. Dollar sign. CAC. Second largest economy in Europe, break 50 day, approaching 200 day also. So ladies and gentlemen, all the signs are there already. I show you the best one, MIB, Men in Black. It represents Italian market. Yeah, first one. Let's go to 10 years. Let's go to 10 years. Because 10 years ago was the so-called the global financial crisis, right? Correct, huh? Correct. 10 years ago, Italy stock market has been ding-dong, cannot even break up. Can you see that? Because Italy has a very serious banking crisis over there. Also, ladies and gentlemen, can go back to my slide. Very short, huh? I say very short, right? So the first phase will be in Europe, and I think it's going to explode next year. Alright, Euro market will continue to go down, Euro will continue to go down. This rally in the Euro is more of because of what? Probably because of US dollar has declined, correct? Ladies and gentlemen, think about it. Europe is still very weak. If Euro continue to strengthen, will it impact their export? So they cannot tahan any more increase for Euro. Remember, just like I say, up down 15%, right? Remember? So it has gone up, you can calculate that 15% 差不多 means about there already. Alright, so ladies and gentlemen, so take note. Then second phase actually in Japan. Yeah, because Japan has a very big debt. And the third one is going to happen in this country called US. And I think it's going to start next year. That's why I say this bull market probably one more year until next year. That's it. Latest 2019. Then you'll be seeing who? Have you watched this movie before called The Big Shot? It's coming. If you don't know what's Big Shot, go and watch a movie. I think we are there on the way already. Remember the guy who played the drug? The doctor? He anxious because the market keep on going up, right? Remember? You never watch, okay? Go and watch a movie called The Big Shot. Alright? He keep on, because he shorted the market, then the market keep on going up. I think this is how George Soros is feeling right now. But one fine day, George Soros will be making them a lot of money. Because the crisis, I believe, should be next year, if not latest 2019. Alright? Can I hope I answered your question. You want to know more later, we can talk later. Alright? Can I?
Sorry, the last question from
everybody. I still have. I didn't overshot. Okay.
Yes, Derek, I just want to ask you about Alibaba. Because under technology, you mentioned.
You look at the chart, Alibaba. Yes, why?
Can we still buy now at this time?
Yeah, this question, I cannot answer. You know, those wearing red, no? No, Derek, this kind of question, like, can we continue to buy? I cannot answer this kind of question. I think your question is, if you were me, would I buy, right? Can you ask the question again? Because you ask me, can buy, I cannot answer. What's your question? Okay. And this question I can answer. Okay. Alibaba, right? Nice enough. No, let's look at probably 5 years. Let's look at 5 years. So, ladies and gentlemen, is quite frankly, it has really shoot up, right? It has really shoot up. If you ask me why buy now, I won't buy now. I hope there will be a pullback. All right. So, to me, it seems to have built a very big cup and handle. If you know technical analysis, very big cup and handle. So the resistance is around probably 110 here. Yeah? The lowest point 60. You take the difference is $50. Resistance is 110, lower 60. Difference is it $50? 50, yeah. You then from 50 you add on to the resistance, 50 plus 110 is about 160, right? So I think that's why around 160, can you see hit the resistance, it ding dong ding dong ding dong, can you see that? Then it kept up and go up again because the result very good, man. So if you ask me anyway, if you ask me why buy now, I won't buy now. But if there's a pullback, I'm definitely very interested because Alibaba is going a lot of places and Ma Yun is a very charisma. He has a lot of charisma. Now he not only go, he not only e-commerce, he go into movie, right? he going to ban all this thing, right? I tell you, maybe Alibaba just stuck on it. But if you ask me, buy now, I won't buy now. I hope there will be a bigger pullback. Alright? Okay?